with our late night show.
Good evening, I'm Jim Lampley, again with Donna DeVerona. We have a show filled with action from various events for you tonight. You're going to see basketball, the one men's swimming event you have not yet seen, the men's triple jump final from track and field, also the 800-meter semifinal heat, which includes Joaquim Cruz of Brazil, Steve Ovett of Great Britain, the world record holder in the 1,500 meters, Johnny Gray of the United States. But Donna, the week has gone by like a whirlwind. Yet, I believe there was action from today alone that people will remember for a long time.
Well, for us, it's a farewell to the swimming events, and it ended appropriately with a 10th world record, the last one set by the U.S. swimming team men's in the 400 medley relay. And I think that demonstrates how strong our American men's program is. Our women didn't break any world records, but they made a medal harvest never equaled before in women's swimming. In track and field, we had Al Joyner top off the evening with a gold medal in the triple jump, and his sister, Jackie Joyner, won the silver in the heptathlon. That brother-sister combination finished now in the competition. Another brother-sister act, Carl Lewis, he set off today with the first gold medal in the 100 meters. Of course, he's attempting that for that tremendous goal that Jesse Owens set a long time ago.
And, of course, his sister Carol will be going for the gold in the women's long jump. But right now, we're going to take you directly to basketball, where Yugoslavia and Italy, two teams with still medal prospects, are in the closing moments of a close game. Let's go to Keith and Digger right away.
Well, Jim, we're in the final seconds of the ball game, and it looks like Yugoslavia is going to win it. It has been something of a struggle throughout. Neither team has played as we have seen them play in the past, but these are neighboring countries, and they've squared off many times against each other and provided some rather extravagant moments in international basketball. And right now, Yugoslavia has a 7-point lead, 68-61. And the winner of this game will play the winner of the China-Uruguay game. The loser will meet Canada in the quarterfinals. And the loser of this game has a pretty tough chore in front of him, Digger.
You better believe it. What happens in this game tonight, Keith, as you look right now at the finesse that's going on, it's not really finesse. It's been a physical bloodbath. A lot of fouls, a few fights, a couple technicals, and right now Hugo's putting it away.
We've also had an unusual piece of officiating, particularly by Reynosa of the United States. He has called some fouls tonight in a ball game involving two teams that love to bang. I mean, they don't mind whacking each other around. They don't mind having a little fist fight now and then. But Reynosa took a lot of the steam out of the ball game early when he started calling some very light contact fouls. And I think that was part of the reason things were slowed down. 68-61 right now. Yugoslavia, the defending champions from the 1980 games in Moscow.
All right, this is the international rule right here that the American people have to get used to. You can either shoot the foul or have the option of taking it out of bounds. And with such a great shooter in Drazen Petrovic, Yugoslavia's going to shoot the foul with a 7-point lead.
You just saw the two coaches there, Gamba first, and now this is Mirko Novosel, the coach of the Yugoslav national team. He was the man that really built the basketball program as much as anybody in Yugoslavia. Then he left the program. It fell into some disrepair. Now he's trying to put it back together.
Mirko got the silver medal for Yugoslavia in 1976 in Montreal. Did not coach the team in Russia, but came back in November to take the national team over and put it back together again, and they're playing as well as they've been, because last year the European Cup, Italy bombed Yugoslavia by 20.
Kinjego is one of the new members of the organization that he's trying to, you know, use him for a brick. He's a relatively young fellow at 27. He's probably got another Olympics in him, because these people tend to go into their middle 30s in those countries. One of the losses for Italy tonight, it happened about 5 minutes ago, was Dino Meninghin actually got 6 fouls. He turned Alexander Petrovic upside down, got his 5th personal plus a technical.
Meninghin,
Dino sitting on the bench.
He's just 34 years old. He's the stone face of this team. He just plays very, very physical. He had 16 points in the second half, and the foul he got really hurt Italy, and this is why the bulge went right back out to where now Yugoslavia is controlling the game.
Well, they didn't go to him that much in the first half either, Digger. They left the ball, sloppy ball handling there by Dalapagic of Yugoslavia, giving Riva a chance, and Riva hits it at the buzzer. At 69-65 with 19 seconds to go, and a timeout called by Gamba. Alessandro Gamba, who played with the Italian team in the 1960 Olympic Games. He was the man assigned to guard Jerry West, and with pride says, I held him to 24.
That's why he decided to become a coach.
He's a good one, though. He's got to get himself now in the process of restructuring his the national program, they've got to bring in some younger people.
This gets to being interesting right now. Yugoslavia wins tonight. They're going to be the number one seed in their bracket. Italy will come into a position where they will play very, very well. What's going to happen, I feel, when we get into the quarterfinals next week, the balance of these European teams, what we saw Spain do for a half against the United States will affect the international play next week. It should be quite interesting as the U.S. tries to go for the golden basketball.
Italy trying to trap on the sidelines. They force Petrovic to the sidelines, and they get an out-of-bound call from Reynosa, the American referee.
This game's still in there. You score here right now. You've got plenty of time. Good shot. You still got a chance to get the possession.
69-55, only 4 points. You've got to get it up in a hurry. Riva, their best shooter, misses the shot. And the ball goes out of bounds to Italy. You've still got 6 seconds to play, but that's a lot to ask for. 4 points in 6 seconds. The other scores of the day, as you've got time called for a moment, Canada beat France 96-69 to qualify for the quarterfinals. The USA routed Spain 101-68. Australia beat Egypt 94-78 to get into the quarterfinals. And West Germany slipped by Brazil. That's a bit of a surprise to me. West Germany beating Brazil 78-75. Detlef Schrempf played all 40 minutes, scored 36 points for West Germany. That's the same Detlef Schrempf that played at the University of Washington.
And that will be the opponent for the United States next week. You've got an American front line playing against West Germany.
Out in front, the shot, no. Off the back iron, the game is over. And Yugoslavia has finished undefeated in Group A, beating Italy 69-65. So it'll be Italy going against Canada in the quarters, and the winner will play the winner of the China-Uruguay game. That game is coming up.